The first story is exciting news that Harvard researchers have unveiled a new technology to investigate autism. And Shannon, this is a pretty dense article. I don't know whether you can untangle the way that this technology works.
Well, it's funny because the thing that I was starting to say was our first story is pretty dense.
Yes.
that was exactly the wording that I was going to give. And I read this last night, and you know me, I just barely get a gripster on it. It's like watching a Christopher Nolan movie. Like
right.
I sort of understand it, and then it slips away from me, and then I sort of understand it, and then it slips away from me again. I think what the takeaway is that it sounds like to me what they're doing is reverse engineering and going, look, we know that something happens genetically with autism. We know that there's a mutation. We know that there's a cascade of events that lead to autism. So what if we work backwards and take the cascade and try to follow it back to a gene expression and to see what happens and then move it forward again and say, if we know all these genes now, but if we take a gene and if we mutate it, let's see what it cascades into. So you're looking at it forward and backward. That's what I got from it. And that they see that this is being very effective in mouse models, that they're seeing how just changing one gene has a cascade that creates one thing, and then another gene cascades to present a different outcome. And so from this, they're extrapolating that not only are they going to potentially find answers to autism, but they are also hopeful that they're going to find answers to cancer, autoimmune disease, and other genetic diseases.
Uh-huh.
This excites me because wouldn't it be like the sweetest thing ever if autism research led to cures for other things like cancer?
Yes, would.
Wouldn't that be just like an amazing thing for us to look back and go, look how we got here?
Exactly.
But in fact, what they're hoping to find is what the gene is that cascades to the more disabling aspects of autism, because then maybe there's a way that they can treat it and prevent the more disabling aspects of autism.
Right, right. So exciting. I think that's a pretty good description, Shannon. That helps me put it in simplistic terms.
You don't think the people at Harvard and MIT are breaking out into hives? It might.
No, I don't think so. I don't think so.
I think.
Yeah. So exciting, exciting news. So we'll have to keep following that.
Yes. Thanks for watching Autism Live. If you found anything helpful in this video, please give us a like. In fact, make sure that you smash that subscribe button on YouTube and give us a like on Facebook. You can also follow us on Twitter and Instagram for important updates. And please download our free podcast wherever you get your podcasts. See you next time. Until then, give your kiddos a hug from me and one for you too. Bye-bye for now.
To subscribe, click here. And if you'd like to check out some more of our videos, click here.